load the Lotus, bring it back up to the plot again, give you a wee look around. This is the area where I grew my corn, but I'm not going to grow any corn in here until I get it a bit more secure against the badgers. This bed here is covered over with the daffs on it. This will be where I'll be planting my peas this year. They done quite well here last year. And this bed here was for salad stuff and root vegetables and stuff like that. The steel bathtub down at the bottom has got gladioli bulbs in it. They'll come up in the summer. This is my broad beans. Some are doing better than others. Couple are dying down there. But we'll see what we get. This is my rhubarb, which is coming out quite well. And in this hole here, once I make it the right size, I'm going to plant this plastic wardrobe in, fill it full of compost, and grow carrots in it. Similar, this is going to be another carrot box. This one here, it's just got my netting in it at the moment. And this one, I've got two little blueberry plants, which this one's coming up quite well. This one's budding up, but nothing on it yet. This is another planter I bought. I was actually going to get you one this, like this, but instead we got you a different one. So a weed. But this is where I grew my carrots last year. And I've got a couple of sacks full of compost potato bags to grow my potatoes in this year. My first earlies. This is my garlic. Needs a bit of a weed, but it's doing okay, I think. Down at the bottom is my tulip bulbs. So I've got a line of tulips going across there. And they're doing okay, I suppose. In this bed is the stump parsnips. There's one there, and there's one there, there. So yeah, still a few parsnips in the ground to be eaten. This is where my main potatoes will grow. There's holes dug in here for the potato pods. And they've all filled in, but the potato pots will go in there. Then at the top, I'll probably grow some beetroot or something. This is my brassica bed. After the pigeons have had a good go at it. That black net was over it, but the stuff went to seed really. And this one, I've got three gooseberry plants and my strawberries. And then this one, this is all my autumn fruit and raspberries. There's one beside each cane. There's not an awful lot of life on here at the moment, but this is starting to come here. You can just see it. This is the black compost bin that was full of rubbish. And this is another one of my compost bins, which is full of rabbit straw mostly. Some bramble weeds are chopped down. Some more bramble weeds are chopped down. And this is where I'll be burning them this afternoon. All this area from the two corrugated iron ones up there, far away ones, all the way along to here. And as far down as here, it's all brambles. You can still see still in the ground. That this bramble, but it's been cut off. All this area was brambles. And and nettles, all the good stuff. This tree, I think it might be a plum tree, I'm not too sure. But the tree behind it on the other plot is a damson tree. So that's the compost that was in the black Dalek. It's all full of all the rubbish. Then this, it's more compost here, but as you can see, it's all got bramble roots in it, which all needs to be taken. Some more bramble roots that are still have to be dug up, and a couple more compost bins. This one's full of last year's compost. And these two bags are full of compost as well, my own compost. So I've got a couple of cold frames there. The windows were on the plot when I took the plot over. So I just made the cold frame boxes and the windows go on top of that. But nothing to go in it at the moment. This is plot number one. This is the first plot we got, and this is plot two, which is hopefully be completed by the end of the summer. Well, there you go, it's a quick tour around the plot. Hope you enjoyed it. Let's see if I can upload this now. I'll speak to you later. Cheerio.